This is another four-player fixed card game which is being played with my subscribers. The purple player is an intermediate, the yellow player is a master, and the blue player is a grandmaster. And I guess it makes me the most sense to go for Africa this time. Though it might not be the most ideal choice either, especially with the blue player having seven troops at the bottom of it. But then the blue player has a lot of troops in Australia, so I think if I had added troops in it, then the blue player would have done that also. So I decided that Africa might be a better shot if I want to get a continent, though if I had added my troops in Australia, then my position might have been much more safe even if the blue player go on for it as well. Because then only the purple player would have gotten a continent from what it seems, while now it seems it will be purple and blue with guaranteed continents, so it means that most likely it will be either me or the yellow player who will get eliminated from the game as the fourth player, so not as much promising. So unless I get to capture and hold Africa, I think purple and blue as small continent players would be much more inclined for me to get Africa, rather than the yellow player North America. But not necessarily, also that's possible that they could decide to target both of us at once. But it might be more efficient for them to target one of us at the time. The purple player removed his troops from my border, so I think he shows me willingness to be a good neighboring player, and with that probably shows that he won't be targeting me, so that's really cool if so, and with that I don't think I should try causing any problems for him. I removed my army from North Africa so the purple player could move his four troops from Africa out. But wasn't really sure if I actually go for it at the end. I thought if the blue player doesn't add a lot of troops in Indonesia and if I get a good set at three cards, then I would just steal Australia from him. But he strengthened Australian border and I didn't have a set, so my plan will be Africa now. Especially when the blue player showed the willingness to get out his troops from Africa too. So that's a promising sign for me. But obviously I shouldn't blindly trust anyone. That's possible that after I finally capture Africa, the blue player could invade me. So I think I will take the thing slow and steady. Though it seems that the yellow player will be the one to get eliminated first anyway, he is the weakest player and differently from all of us three has already traded in a set. But I'm not sure if I really trust blue, he doesn't show the intention to weaken yellow, so that might be possible that after trading an A set he will use his troops on crushing me, while the purple player really seemed to go after yellow. So I'm not really sure how it turns out to be, that could be possible that I will get targeted as well, but we are going to see how it goes. So maybe that's why I'm delaying on capturing Africa. The blue and purple players have strong positions and are guaranteed holding their continents, while Africa for me would be very vulnerable with me having to guard three borders. So I wanted to at least trade an A set before capturing it. Unfortunately I've got the worst set, but with the purple player fortifying a big stack of troops next to yellow, I think he will be going to take him out. So I decided to increase the odds of doing so by manual rolling and weakening the yellow player's army. Even though Africa is very vulnerable, I know that with the yellow player having his army blocked from me and having only two cards, he won't be able to retaliate. And unless the blue player decided to attack me, I thought the yellow player will get straightly eliminated before he even makes his next turn. But either way, in that sense of me using my troops on yellow was very risky. I kinda did the dirty work for the blue player who was having a strong position and wasn't attacking anyone, so it could have really backfired me if the blue player would have decided to attack me instead of taking the yellow player out. But I mean, I didn't want the game to stalemate, as if we all hoard troops, then the game will just stagnate. Now getting to the three player situation and being in a very vulnerable position, I'm not so sure what to do, as I think attacking any of the players will probably result of me getting invaded into Africa, so the purple and blue player are in much better positions having respectively South America and Australia. But I think it might be worth a try of trapping the blue player in Australia, so next to Africa I'm capturing Europe, so by putting my armies to the territories of Middle East and Ukraine I would be properly guarding against blue. But only after capturing Middle East I realized that with me capturing Europe I actually unleash the blue player's way towards Europe, And I mean, it wasn't even possible for me to capture Europe without unleashing the blue player's way towards Europe at the first place. So by realizing that I actually messed up, at the end I didn't even leave any troops on Ukraine so not to get crushed them by blue. And now with the purple player crushing one of the blue player's armies, I'm actually wondering if I should take the blue player out. Too bad I didn't have any set. And besides that, the purple player seemed to be relatively strong with having two bigger armies and a lot of territories. So I decided that I won't even try manual rolling the blue player, and since it was unknown if the blue player actually has a set at 4 cards, it wouldn't have been a great idea to weakening him anyway if not having the intention to take him out. So with that, the most reasonable decision for me was to attack purple. Or maybe like not to attack anyone, but like maybe just making a few manual rolls on the blue player. But I was getting stronger and didn't really want to not do anything, just hoarding my troops. The purple player says oops and good game, but is it really a good game? Looking to the troops counter, my opponents have 16 troops more than me combined, the blue player only has 2 cards, and then almost all of the blue player's troops in his army, while the purple player a lot of troops and armies too. So if I had taken the blue player out, then I think I would have given the game away for the purple player. So I just decided to use my troops on manual rolling the blue player, but not having an intention to take him out. I did so as the strongest player, I would waste some troops on someone so the game wouldn't stalemate as much. And then I was a little bit hoping that the purple player might follow me and weaken the blue player as well, even after him saying good game. But as you can see, the purple player was smart, and by looking at the troops counter, he obviously knew that he was supposed to attack me. Now as the strongest player, if I have to attack someone, then I think I will attack South America, taking over it and then wiping the blue player's troops from North America so he would just be in A1 place. And then I decided to capture a bunch of territories to potentially increase my territorial troop bonus. I mean, these territories will probably be quickly recaptured anyway, but I mean, if I don't want the game to be dragged out, then I have to use my troops in making attacks. As I mean, in this game we all know about the balance of the game and are going to suicide on each other randomly, so by knowing the turtling strategies wouldn't work, it's just the best to use our troops on each other. The goal is that our troop numbers would stay at low numbers. As otherwise, if everyone has large armies of troops, then it could become really impossible to end the game playing with smart players. Now since the purple player is showing the intention to make me block in Asia and guard only against me, obviously I had to invade him as the strongest player. And then that I noticed is if I fortify my biggest army in the territory of Venezuela after wiping the blue player territories from Asia, then he will have to go through a bunch of the purple player territories. But alright, that works. Also, obviously he was very likely going to have a set at 4 cards, so I will admit that maybe it wasn't that as smart to try blocking him when he had a bunch of cards. Hopefully the purple player doesn't overattack me now, as with that he could give away the game for the blue player. But the good news is that I have a set, so I will stay alive either way, as the purple player doesn't have enough troops to take me out. Which I decided to not trade in anyway, because with the purple player's biggest army being cut off from Australia and with it blocking the path for the purple player as well, and finally with the purple player sitting at 2 cards, I knew there would be no way for someone to take me out, and then I didn't want to trade in a set to appear being weaker. And I'm still weak. So just a bunch of territories of ones is making my troops count high. But I guess not that much anymore with the purple player capturing a bunch of them, though with trading in a good set I should still be where I was. Let's actually recapture some of them, but probably not too many, as otherwise I think I would be risking of giving a huge advantage to the blue player. So yeah, I think that's more than enough. And actually I'm not sure why mostly I was focused on purple. Well, I guess it's because the blue player keeps his troops and armies and basically doesn't attack many territories at all or barely. But the thought which came to my mind is that I should be supposed to mostly focus on attacking the player who has the turn after me but not before me, and it's because that the player who has a turn after you would still have a turn to attack that another player to save the balance of the game if needed. while if you attack the player who has a turn before you, then you could risk of giving a very good position for another player, as that player will instantly receive all the troop bonuses after you ending your turn. So theoretically in the three-player situation by attacking the player who has a turn after you, you could force him to attack the player who has a turn before you. Like you could attack that player that much that he would have no other choice but to attack that another player, so the balance of the game would be saved, so it just could be relatively risky and you would need to be very precise, and obviously before doing that you would need to be sure that that weakened player actually has the access to attack that player and affords weakening him enough. Important notice though. I would probably recommend applying it when you know that you're playing with decent players who know about the balance of the game well and don't suicide based on emotions, so probably in public lobbies it wouldn't be so smart to try using this strategy, so unless you don't care that much about losing, but if you play with decent players from Discord, or in a group of smart risk friends, then it might be an interesting strategy to try and play with. So anyway, as you noticed, I stopped seriously attacking purple, as one thing I'm not the strongest player anymore, and then another thing next to that is that it's the blue player's job to take care of the player who has the turn after him, so now with him being stronger than me I'm not going to attack the purple player anymore if the blue player doesn't either. As besides all of that, what I noticed is that blue mostly tries to stay away out from action, barely making any attacks, and probably hopes that I and the purple player will over-attack each other, giving him an easy victory. I think with the purple player being intermediate, the blue player probably hopes to honey trap him, trying to appear being way too friendly to him so he could possibly give away him the game, and that almost worked, as I was always invading the purple player by myself. But now when I stopped doing the dirty work, the purple player is going to highly surpass both of us the troop-wise if the blue player doesn't attack him. As with him being stronger than me and being the player who has a turn before purple, he is the one who is supposed to attack purple over me. But alright, the blue player after trading an ace set goes to take me out, and that's something what I didn't see coming, and I mean I didn't even expect him to have a set at 3 cards at the first place. But that's really interesting to see how the endgame turns out for him. The good thing for the blue player is that the purple player's biggest army is blocked, so I think it was the main reason behind the blue player taking me out, as I think if the purple player's army wasn't blocked, then I don't think he would have gone for me. But looking back at the troops counter, I would say it was very risky anyway. I mean the blue and purple players had the same number of troops each. So the purple player had 3 cards while the blue player 0, and with the blue player needing to take down 35 troops of mine, I think they were way too much just for the blue player end up getting 3 cards which would match him the card wise with purple, but not the troops 1, even with the purple player's biggest army being blocked, so unless with that the blue player would have been able to hold some big continents for a turn in some way. But unfortunately for him, Australia was the only continent he held. So the purple player gets a very easy endgame victory at the end. And I will admit that the purple player was playing way above intermediate level, and I felt like I was playing with another grandmaster, so props to him for that, and hopefully he reaches higher ranks soon. Now if you enjoyed watching this gameplay, then I would recommend you watching another insane fixed card video which was played with my subscribers as well. That's another 4-player fixed card game on Classic Risk map with an insane strategy.